Hey there, YouTube. This is a real impromptu video. Pardon my messy desk, but I'm doing a lot of stuff, a lot of really cool stuff. So when I'm doing stuff on my PC, my laptop, I've got some software called Debut, and it does screen capture, and it does it really well. I'll leave a link down there in the description. The problem is, when I'm doing stuff like CNC or my Raspberry Pi, it just doesn't have the bandwidth to capture the screen. The computer is just simply not fast enough. And so what do I do about that? Well, I need to capture the screen. I don't have a way of doing it, so I grab a GoPro and I take the GoPro and I try and stick it in front of the screen, and you know, that just doesn't work. It just doesn't work. So I've been kind of depressed about that. It's like, I want to do these great videos, but I can't capture the screen. But that all changed. I was on Amazon and I was looking for some stuff, and I found this little guy right here. And this is really good. I'm going to leave a link down in the description. It does not need a computer to record. This thing works so well. It's amazing. So say I wanted to do something on the screen and I wanted to share it with you, right? First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to shut my thing down, log out, shut it down, okay? And I'm going to turn off the power. Now, the next thing I do is I plug in a little HDMI cable here. I plug in the power supply here. And I can take the HDMI cable out of here and plug this one in its place, just like that, and then take this and plug it into the monitor. So now the video will pass through this little device. Then I simply take a thumb drive, I plug the thumb drive into here like that, and we're good to go. So I turn the power on and start bringing the computer up. By the way, you can also plug a microphone into it so that you can narrate. And yes, that's from the last century. That's from like 1998. But hey, it still works, so I'm fine. Now, you'll notice the screen looks purple. So when I got this thing, I was all excited and I plugged it in and I got this kind of horrible looking screen and I was like, oh man, I got a broken device. I'm very disappointed. I wrote to the manufacturer, and they got back to me within an hour and was like, no, it's that sometimes you have to switch between RGB and another mode. So just go into your menu and make the switch. And I was like, all right, let's try that. So I open my menu, right? I come down here to color settings. I tell it okay. I go in here and I tell it okay. And I switch the color mode and tell it okay. And what do you know? The colors are perfect. So it's a little thing I got to do whenever I switch between here is I have to change the color screen. Certainly worth it. Because now, if I wanted to show you something that I was doing, I could go in here and I could, let's say I start my terminal up and tell it I want to run, you know, some, oops, wait. There we go. So tell it I want to run some software, and I can bring the software up, and now I can start showing you guys stuff, because I'm doing stuff with the Raspberry Pi. I've got some really cool experiments going on. I'm playing around with extenders and analog to digital circuits and a whole bunch of stuff, and I want to be able to share it. So I've got a program called Gambus, and I'm going to do a series on it, and Gambus is basically it's almost like Visual Basic. It's a version of Basic. And some of you guys are saying, well, what are you playing around with Basic for? That's a beginner's language and everything else. Well, number one, I started programming in Basic back in 1978, so I'm very familiar with it. Number two, I can make these great graphical displays, and I can resize the graphical display anywhere I want. I can go into it, and I can change the background color if I want to, you know. Whatever I want to do, I can make it look like whatever I want. I can go into a label and I could, you know, change the foreground color of the of the label to be, you know, some other color or whatever. Change the font size and all kinds of stuff. And doing that kind of stuff in C or in Python or some of the other ones, it's very difficult. And so it allows me the capability of creating some really cool graphical displays and being able to control stuff. And I'm very excited to bring you this series. So, yeah, this is going to be great. And it's all because of this little box. And to use this little box is so simple. Right now I'm in 1080p. If I wanted to, I could just touch it like this. And I can switch to 720p. But the 1080p is beautiful, and I'm going to show you a quick little example of what it looks like. It's absolutely fabulous. And then for me to record, I just hold this down. It'll make a little burr noise. You'll see that. Now it's recording. So now it's recording the screen. And like if I wanted to show you my code, I could go like this. And here's my code. And it's absolutely stunningly clear. And I'm going to be able to share it. People are going to be able to follow along. And so I'm very excited about that. I think it's going to be really good. And that's what I've got for right now. Like I said, I'm going to put the files, the links that you're going to need down below. So go ahead and, I mean, if you're looking for a video capture, this thing is great. They just came out with a 4K one. I don't need a 4K for what I'm doing here, but for doing some other high resolution, you gamers and stuff, yeah, it's awesome. And as soon as they come out with that and I get a link for it, I'll make sure that I post that as well. And then when you're done recording, you just hold this button in for a couple of seconds like that. You'll feel it vibrate and it's done. Now your videos are on the thumb drive and you can just remove the thumb drive and go. Personal thing, I don't like disconnecting cables with the power on, so I always shut it down. And then I'll kill the power and remove everything. But that's all there is to it. I've got my video. I've got that video. Now it's time for me to edit it and get it on YouTube. So I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think. And like I said, within the next few days, I'm hoping to have a couple of videos on there on the Raspberry Pi and some programming in Gambus and running light bulbs and switches and LEDs and whatever else I can think of. So... thanks for watching.